Yes, it is true, the almighty Seoul has fallen to New York in the most exciting way possible. New York's synergy seemed just as good as Seoul's, and there were so many times where Seoul would lose like three people and would still end up getting the objective back. But I gotta say, when I saw Sabi Obli for the first time at the World Cup, I knew he would quickly be regarded as likely the best tracer in the world, but everyone was busy talking about Flower at the time instead. And Sabi Obli did not disappoint. This was also my first real introduction to Libero, who really made a name for himself in this match, as well as Jonak. One of the things that shocked me was that they didn't bring in Pine at all for any map in this series. So it kind of begs the question, would it have been easier or harder if New York's Pine were put on stage? A lot of New York's success was just being able to shut down Fleta whenever possible. Now, it's not like with FaZe where Shadowburn did everything incredible, so his team really just backed him up, and if he was shut down, then the rest would just fall apart. Seoul has top players in each role, and is actually very experienced and skilled at protecting Fleta because they knew he would be the bait in a dive, typically. However, New York played that to their strength, I guess, and were able to capitalize on Seoul peeling for Fleta by getting a pick of their own during any small window where Fleta was preoccupied. Of course, it was all way more complex than that, but that's just the gist, it seems to me. Regardless, the back and forth emotions I was feeling during this match was insane. There were moments where I was just happy that New York competed at Seoul's level at all, and other moments where I would believe New York would actually win. Yeah, that roller coaster of emotions happened every 5 minutes for 2 hours. They actually ended up tying 2-2 with the final map being on Lijiang Tower, where the first round reached 99% for both teams, and really, I thought Seoul was able to take it back until I saw it was actually New York that won the overtime. Then the next round, Seoul had only gotten like 24%, I think, before New York pushed it to overtime and eventually won. My jaw dropped. It seems like every week we're saying these games are the best Overwatch games we've ever seen, so I'll say it for this match for sure. If you haven't seen it yet, I'll leave a link to the VOD on Twitch, and please check it out. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to share, like, and subscribe to the channel. Are you happy that New York won? Are you sad that Seoul lost? Which is it? Let me know in the comments below. Did you see the match? Did you not see the match? Well, that's it, everybody. My name is Chit, and I approve this message.